So in this video, I'm going to talk about how you can balance your estrogen levels in order to help balance your other hormones. So the one thing that you may not be aware of when it comes to estrogen balance or estrogen dominance is that we need to be able to metabolize and excrete estrogen out of our body once our body has made use of it. We also need to think about how our other body systems will support this process. If your body has difficulty breaking down or excreting estrogen, you may be experiencing a state of estrogen dominance or having too much estrogen in your body. This may be one reason why some women are at higher risk for estrogen-associated diseases at midlife. If you're worried about any of your symptoms at all, it's really important to go and see your doctor to make sure that he or she can rule out any health issues that you may not know about. When it comes to diet and lifestyle, there are do's and don'ts that you may need to do to help balance your estrogen levels. So tip number one is to add lots of cruciferous vegetables in your diet, and these are your cabbages, kale, cauliflower, pak choi, Brussels sprouts, and similar foods. Cruciferous vegetables have compounds that will help to break down estrogen into the healthier byproducts of metabolism. And because estrogen is a fat-soluble hormone, these cruciferous vegetables will contain the compounds that will help to break down estrogen into more water-soluble compounds so your body can get rid of it effectively. So tip number two is to add green leafy vegetables, fiber-rich foods, and fermented foods in your diet. Now, flax seeds is an example of a fiber-rich food that you can add into your soups or smoothies. Flax seeds provide the bulk and the fiber to bind estrogen in your gut, as well as encourage bowel movements and omega-3 fatty acids to support your immune system. Around 95% of serotonin is made in your gut, and serotonin is one of your happy hormones. So by adding fiber in your diet, you're supporting the balance of beneficial bacteria in your gut, which will then help to support the production of serotonin. Feeding the beneficial bacteria will also support the production of B vitamins in your gut, helping to increase your energy levels, improve your moods, as well as supporting any digestive issues that you may have. So the purpose of adding fermented foods in your diet is to help provide you with natural sources of probiotics. And this is to help reduce the production of compounds that may release estrogen back into your circulation. So tip number three is to add lots of multicolored vegetables and fruits in your diet. So estrogen is now known to support our immune system. So as our estrogen levels drop, it will have an effect in lowering our immune system. And this is where you need to start adding a variety of multicolored fruits and vegetables in your diet to help support your immune system as your estrogen levels drop. When your immune system becomes less effective due to the drop in estrogen levels, you may have a state where your body starts creating oxidative stress. Oxidative stress is a state where your body is being overwhelmed by the toxins, and as a result, this may affect the production and balance of hormones in your body. So by adding lots of colored fruit and vegetables in your diet, you're supporting your immune system to keep your hormones in balance. So tip number four is add lots of quality proteins in your diet, whether it's from animal or plant-based sources. Protein provides the amino acids to help the phase two detoxification process when it comes to detoxifying estrogen. So tip number five is to drink plenty of water. This is because your liver is really important when it comes to breaking down and excreting estrogen and other used hormones, as well as other toxins. So we've already talked about estrogen being broken down and being made water soluble, so it's easier for your body to mix it with other body fluids such as bile and urine. And bile is produced in the liver, so it's really important to support your body with lots of water to help this process. Drinking sufficient amounts of water also helps to keep your stool soft, helping to encourage regular bowel movements and getting rid of those used hormones out of your body. Step number six is adding lots of healthy fats in your diet. Healthy fats provide the building blocks to produce and balance your hormones. So tip number seven is to get more active, to encourage blood circulation, to transport nutrients and oxygen around your body, to nourish your ovaries, your adrenal glands, and other systems that help to produce and balance your hormones. Getting active also means you're encouraging bowel movements to get rid of the byproducts of estrogen metabolism to support estrogen and other hormone balance. So tip number eight is to take time out for rest and relaxation. And we've already talked about the effects of stress when it comes to hormone balance. So it's really important that although you do need to get active, you also need to take time out, whether it's reading a book, going for a walk, taking a warm bath, meditation, or just mindfulness. These activities are really important to relaxing you and decreasing the levels of stress hormones in your body that may be causing a hormone imbalance and causing you to experience worse menopause symptoms. So if you've got benefit from the information I've shared so far, I'd love you to hit the like button so that YouTube knows to share this video with other women who may benefit from the information that I share here. So now let's get to the don't do's when it comes to balancing estrogen and other hormones. Or better put, let's talk about what to cut down on. The first thing to cut down on is sugary and processed foods as well as alcohol. All these foods changes the balance of your gut bacteria to the more non-beneficial bacteria. The imbalance of your gut bacteria may increase the compounds that recirculate estrogen around your body. Sugar and the subsequent release of insulin may actually speed up menopause faster because they may cause your ovaries and your egg reserves to age faster. So tip number two to cut down on is the use of beauty products and toiletries, as well as drinking or eating food from plastic containers, namely because they may release compounds known as xenoestrogens into your body. So xenoestrogens are compounds that act like estrogen in your body, binding with your estrogen receptors and causing changes in your DNA, and as a result may cause an imbalance in your hormone levels. Because they're sitting on your estrogen receptors, your natural estrogen are just circulating in your body, not being used, and keeping your estrogen levels higher than they should be because your estrogen can't dock with your estrogen receptors. So tip number three to cut down on is to cut down on processed foods and foods that have been cooked at high temperatures. Processed and foods cooked at high temperatures also changes our cell structure, and this will have a negative effect on your metabolism and hormone production. So it's really important to cook from scratch where possible. That way you'll know what's going into your food and into your body to support estrogen production and hormone balance. So if you've got benefit from the video so far, I'd love you to hit the like button so YouTube knows to share this video with other women who may benefit from the information I share here. Also, if you'd like more information to support you on your menopause journey, remember to subscribe and hit the bell notification so you never miss a video when I post it. And until next time, I'll see you then.